Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life.
Town of my childhood, town of my dreams, I'm tied to the place where I once grew. It's got no culture, it's got no arts, but I know those faces, I love those hearts. It's a hick town, sure it is, but I don't mind because in it I can.
Welcome to Our Town, the local history quiz that has city slickers battling against townies with their locals' insider knowledge on everything historical. Historical meaning anything between the Ice Age and last night. Each week we invite four relatively knowledgeable characters from the area to show us what they know, who they know, where it happened, and most importantly, when. This week, our guests are obviously our regular captains, Jax. Hi Jax, how are you?
I'm very well, thanks, Andy.
How long have your family lived in the city? Or town, gosh. I would say town. Would you say town?
Town, I always say town. Yeah.
1930.
Oh, before that, was it? Yeah, 1930s, definitely. Probably before that. My father's family were before that.
You wonder why she may be talking to the person next door to her, because obviously the person next door to her is Becky, who, unbelievably, is a relative of Jack's and is actually her daughter. So you're interested, a bit like your mother, in nostalgia. We're not going to call you Raffle Jax, but you are interested in the city.
Yes.
And is that... because mum made you, or...?
No, because I love the city.
Good.
Love the city. Fantastic. My grandparents are from here, my great-grandparents, so we have a...
They loved the hotel, didn't they?
Yes, and also on my father's side, we've been here for many years as well, so...
And obviously on the other side, I have usual Captain Carroll, and your family's been in the town for what, over 100 years?
Yeah, just over 100 years.
Because you traced them and you've found them and where they live.
Yeah, Lewis before Brighton, but yeah.
Lewis
around
before...
the area for a long, long time.
But with you today, we have obviously another expert who we all know, Rainier. How long has your family been in the town?
Personally, I've been here since 1961.
But
my grandfather used to live in Hove in the 20s.
And we've talked a lot before, but your interest really is... pre-Regency, isn't it?
It is really, yes, because everyone knows the history post-Regency, so I'm examining it pre-Regency.
There's a lot of stuff went on, isn't there?
A lot of stuff went on, and a lot more than people think.
Normally, we wait till later in the show to see what the teams have brought in to show us, an item with a smidgen of local history attached. But I'm curious, Carol, as to what you've brought in next week. So let's have a look.
Well, I've borrowed this off of a friend because I've run out of things to bring in.
No, you haven't. And
this belonged to Mr. Hannington. I'm not sure which Mr. Hannington, but this belonged to Hannington's of North Street fame. North Street, East Street, yeah. And apparently he's got secret little compartments in there for his money. They picked it up from the sale when they closed Hannington's in 2001. Okay. They picked up this bag.
For those of you who aren't from Brighton, Hannington's basically was from the bottom of... from the end of East Street all the way up North Street.
Yes.
And was probably one of the biggest local department stores that we had. And it was proper. And as we were talking earlier, proper Mr. Grace, wasn't it? Proper Grace,
was.
Grace Brothers.
Very much. Yeah.
So there were lots of Mrs. Slocums and Mr. Humphreys. Anyway, Jax, now I understand you've got a picture of
the
house.
It's a modern picture by Lisa Holcroft of my house.
Oh, wow.
I brought it in because the house was built probably in 1825. The first houses in Marine Square were built in 1824 and they were opposite me, numbers 3 and 4, five, and then I'm opposite, 27, 28. So it's probably 1825 it's built, and she paints the house, and it's beautiful, as you can see, and my cat's there, who's just died, which is nice, so she personalised it, and they're wonderful, and she'll always paint people's houses. She's very, very good at architectural pictures.
Because you obviously know who owned the land that they built Marine Square on.
Yes, I do. Yes, you Carol? Tell me.
Kemp.
No.
Cubitt.
No, Attree.
It was the builder, wasn't it?
Attree.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, of course it was, yes, of course it was.
So we'll find out more about your hidden past later. Meanwhile, it's a general quiz round. So last week we did old cinemas. So let's have a round now with great films made in Brighton. Who is this chap? At the time of his funeral, all the cinemas in Brighton held a 2-minute silence out of respect. Anybody?
No, it looks like Holly.
Who?
Carol's.
No, it's not. So, no idea who that is?
No.
Well, that was actually William Freeze Green.
Oh, is it? Oh, the photographer.
Yeah, who was known as the father of the motion picture. One of the earliest film pioneers who did a lot of stuff down in Brighton.
Yes.
We're now actually going to go and see a little film about making films in Brighton.
So you think that Hollywood is the home of cinema? Come off it! If you're after the real birthplace of the silver screen, look no further than Brighton. While Tinseltown was still a village, Brighton was setting the pace. First use of special effects? Brighton. First female filmmaker? Brighton. First ever book adaptation? Brighton. First use of fancy montage effects? Brighton. First ever war cameraman? Brighton. First ever colour film? Brighton. And first ever blue movie? Brighton. Because when it comes to innovation, creativity, and keeping it real to real, in Brighton Brill.
Right, next question. Which British film star was a director of Brighton Hove Albion from 64 to 70 and lived in Sussex for several years? Any ideas, anybody?
No.
Clue? Right, okay. His first film was called Trouble in Store.
No.
No? Oh, dear me.
Don't do sport,
not Laurence Olivier.
No, no. Norman Gilbert. Wisdom.
Oh.
There you go. There he is, look.
You like him, don't you?
He's lovely.
Yeah.
Right, so the next photo. So here's a picture. What's the film? Who are the actors? Where's it shot? And why is Jack so interested?
End of the Affair with Ralph Fiennes.
Videra Terraces underneath.
And Ralph Fiennes and...
Juliet something or other.
Yeah, they filmed it all along Kemp Town, didn't they?
Yeah.
Bottom of
Bloomsbury.
I can't
think what I said. I've got the answers. No, so it's obviously interesting to Jacks because it's...
Yeah, Madeira Terraces, yes. Good picture.
There's Julianne Moore, yeah.
Ah, that's it.
Yeah, shot in the terraces, which were obviously not quite as rotten as they were. I wonder if they filmed it there now.
Allowed to walk underneath it, yeah.
Incidentally, in that film, Neil Jordan, who the director, also shot scenes in the Royal Pavilion.
I've not seen it.
And the pier.
Yeah, Bloomsbury Place.
I've got Eastern Terrace here, but Bloomsbury Place.
Belgrave Square as well.
Yeah. Talking of Neil Jordan, here he is directing his lead actor in a film shot in 1986. Easy to guess where. What's the movie?
It's Bob Hoskins' Mona Lisa, is it?
Excellent, yes. All about London gangsters and prostitutes, and I just remember in the film they had a run around the Albion Hotel in all the corridors. And on the pier.
It was on the Palace Pier.
Here's an easy one. Which actor played the role of Pinky Brown in Brighton Rock?
Richard Attenborough.
Do we know what his first film was?
Jurassic Park.
Much later.
Here's a little clip of it now.
Not Oh, What a Lovely War.
It is Oh, What a Lovely War. Well done.
I thought there was an error.
And we're going to see a quick clip of it now.
What's astonishing about the film was that all of it was shot in Brighton and all the key scenes were shot on the West Pier.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Wipe the tear, baby dear, from your eye. Though it's hard to part, I know I'll be tickled to death to go to cry.
Question.
It is great.
So this film is still shown a lot on TV. Bit of a clue. The main actor played Dixon the Dot Green.
Yeah. Jack Warner.
Yeah.
Jigsaw.
Correct. See, Jackie knows that.
Okay.
Is that Peace Haven?
It's Salt Dean, actually. The Daily Worker said about Brighton on filming, it was always good for a murder. Which, before we go to the break, which Brighton actor said, without acting, I cannot breathe? Don't hold your breath. We'll find out the answer after the break.
Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life. Proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life.
And welcome back. And before the break, we asked which Brighton actor said, "Without acting, I cannot breathe." Any idea?
Olivier.
Olivier, yes, thank you, Miriam. Fantastic. Lord Laurence Olivier, who also had the title of Baron Olivier of Brighton, which is first actor to reach the House of Lords. Next question. So, you all know this film. Excellent.
It's a new street.
Yes.
Running the Rampage.
Yeah. And who was the face? Yeah,
Sting.
Yeah. What was his name in the film?
The Face.
Yeah.
Yes.
It was The Face. And he actually was the bit that they loved is when he wrote a cheque in the court. Do you remember that bit?
Yeah.
That's it. Not seen the film?
A bit modern for you.
Too busy having children. Sorry about that. Renya, you were in a film though, weren't you? Down there.
No.
Television.
Not a film, but I was in a children's TV show as a member of the audience. They filmed two back to back.
What was it called?
5 o'clock Club.
Well, I...
Hosted by Pussycat Willem, who was a puppet.
A puppet?
Yes, excellent. And they filmed two episodes or two programmes back to back. One starred Lulu and the other one starred, I think, Donovan.
Donovan and Lulu? You remember those, Jackson?
I could be wrong.
But apparently, Jax has got a... On the
Palace Pier.
On the Palace Pier, or the Brighton Marine Palace Pier.
As it was.
And talking about filming, Jax, you were in or not in?
No, I was not in two of the major films. I was not in Oh, What a Lovely War, though I was asked to be in it as an extra, because when I was going to go down there to do my part, I put my Mary Quant tights on that cost 15 shillings a pair then, when that was made, and one leg was half the length of the other. And so I lost my temper and wouldn't go. Oh. And then I was going to be in Quadrophenia, and I was young then, obviously, and I used to be a mod, a very young mod, and then they asked me to be a mother pushing a pram, so I wouldn't do it. No way.
Later, you said on that. You said, I'll do that later with Bex.
Yes, with Bex. Yeah.
So, finally, sticking with Quadrophenia, what's special about this year on it? It's
anniversary.
Yeah.
How many?
40 years.
Yes, well done, Rainer. 40. Oh, the mods ride again. Let's have a quick look.
The mods are back on the pier, but not to worry. The Riot this time is just a remake of the iconic film Quadrophenia. Talking of which, Bane, a movie with Mark Wingert as his character Dolly in Quadrophenia, was shot on the pier this year, and to commemorate the moment, a plaque was unveiled this weekend.
So there are so many things you can ask about films in Brighton, so we'll visit that topic again. Meanwhile, from Brighton Films, moving to Brighton and Hove Hotels, which is relevant on this table because obviously we've got Jax's family heavily involved. So we've come up with some suitable questions, which we're grateful to David Bramwell and Tim Bick's Cheeky Guide to Brighton for some of the information. So here is our quizmaster Bill in a bath in a Brighton hotel.
Oh.
What's the hotel and what's the USP? Any idea?
The Grand?
Which one?
Grand.
No.
What's it mean? What's USP?
USP is their special selling, unique selling point.
Oh, the ship, then.
The what, sorry? No, it's not. It's not.
You're wrong.
The Albion. No, it's Drake's.
Okay.
Hotel.
I don't call that a hotel.
We can't call
Marine
that.
Brighton. It's a hotel. It's a boutique
hotel. I've eaten there in a restaurant downstairs.
Yeah. They'll prepare. You'll prepare your room however you wish it, madam. Mm. Which is
move the bath from one side to the
other. Didn't Kylie Minogue stay there?
Yeah. You have your bath in the window with no curtains so people can see your bath.
It's a long way up, probably. And in fact, if you're walking along that part of the seafront, you're probably either drunk or you've got no idea where you are. Which hotel in Brighton has a do not disturb bedspread of knitted seagulls? And it's designed by artist Kate Cardigan.
Pelagroco,
yes.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Is it?
Well done. See? Glad you brought your daughter, because it makes it so much easier to get the questions right. one for you, Jax. Easy one. Which film actress owned a hotel on the seafront?
Dora Bryant, just along the road.
Carry on.
Yes, wonderful character.
I served her when I worked in Woolworths in St James's.
And that was my first ever job when I was still at school, was cooking toast for breakfast in the gorgeous hotel.
So you got good toast as a child, then?
Yes. Oh, lovely toast. We loved toast.
And what was Dora's husband's name?
Bill Lawton. And
Bill
he was
Lawton.
A cricketer.
He was a professional, professional cricketer, certainly was.
Yorkshire Cricket Club.
And any idea of her best-known films?
Oh, yes.
No?
Yes. Taste of Honey?
Yep.
I would say that was the best-known film. Probably the best film.
Yeah, probably. Hello, Dolly.
Oh, yes, I didn't like that much.
So, someone's written this question down and said, so, Jax, what was the average price for a hotel room in 1966?
Oh,
I'll throw that over to everyone else if anyone can.
Well, my parents' ones, I remember it was in guineas, and I think it was like 2 guineas for a week.
1906.
Yeah. Shillings and guineas, that's £2, 2 shillings.
Yes. Yeah,
well, apparently, the average price in 1966 was 5 shillings.
A night, that must be.
A bus, probably, yeah.
Not for a week.
No,
must be a night.
For a room, yeah.
Well, yes.
For a night, which makes £2, 2 shillings about right, doesn't it, really?
Yeah.
OK. £25 a week, yeah. So, what was it like having a family hotel, Jax? Did you get involved? Or?
Yeah, ours was small, but yeah, yes. We had, it's called a hotel, but it was more a guest house.
Right.
So you'd, we had to stay away from the guests in our rooms.
We've sort of gone through hotels and there's the oldest hotel in Brighton is what?
The old ship,
I think. Yeah. I mean, that's pre-Regency, just sort of bring that one in. Isn't it? And there's a balcony in there. Does anyone know what it's famous for?
Not for Cordofenia.
No. Bit before that.
For jumping.
It's the assembly rooms, which got a feature, which is one of the oldest parts of the building, which is about in the 1760s. And there's the Paganini rooms, because Paganini played.
Oh yes, I've been there.
It's been compared to the modern day Nigel Kennedy, who's also got a Brighton connection, and that's. Well, there's Paganini played in the ballroom on the balcony.
Oh,
is he?
Hmm. So what's the latest you're doing at the moment then, Raina? What are you looking into at the moment? Anything specific?
I bounce from theme to theme, but I'm going back and rereading, proofreading and editing what I've...
Right.
Some of the earlier
stuff. So is that a plug for a book?
Yes.
Good, excellent. Jax, it's about time you did a book.
Book, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't got the time to do it, but...
So busy. Raffle Jax. Carol, about time you did a book as well.
I'm working on it.
I'm just plugging them all. all doing a good book.
And Becky's going to get my grandparents' and mother's bits together.
Yes,
letters and photos and stuff.
Fantastic. Yeah. That's what we need. We need
not make a book.
We need more social history about real things.
I feel that they should have a museum. It would be lovely to have a... But people donate, some photos. We have some beautiful things.
I mean, Carol, you know a bit more about, and Carol, about the museum. They have got a lot of this stuff anyway, haven't they?
Yeah. They've got tons of stuff that we've never seen.
But you, But, it, yeah, does it go back to the Ice Age? Probably not.
Well, it's the very new...
The new exhibition.
..room has opened up, which, yeah, which is really good. ..which is impressive and interesting.
Because that's right up your street, I would have thought, wouldn't it?
It's not one I'm an expert on, but no, in examining the history of Brighton, I've obviously had to go that far back in my researches.
I think all of us together, we're, none of us are experts, but we have a unique knowledge of bits that we're all interested in. Mm. And I think that with Becky doing the stuff from that part of history, it's very much what people want to see. And the same with on Facebook, the Facebook sites. They want to see the pictures of what things look like. You know, I see everyone here put stuff on there.
I like the little film of the mammoth walking across the Steen. During one of the glacial periods or after it.
Yeah, we might actually get... We just need to show that. That's good fun. Right, so thank you to our guest, Becky. Well done. Great. And Jax, of course, as ever. Thank you. Carol, as ever. And if you want to write to us, our email is ourtown@thelatest.co.uk. With any questions or anything you want me to ask our panellists or our guests or our captains... Thanks very much. See you next time. To my hip town, kicking time in the slick town. Feeling at home in this ghost town. There's no spooks in this happy town. Hick, hick, ha, oh
yeah. Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove. Helping people in our city make the most of later life. The